Into our midst this morning. Isn't it wonderful that it doesn't matter where we are, the presence of the Lord is there with us. Whether you're here in the sanctuary, He is here. And if you are in your home or you are anywhere where you have logged in online, you know you have connected to the Spirit through your device, and the presence of the Lord is there with you. So let's welcome the presence of the Lord. God, we welcome you within this place. Holy Father God, we welcome you within this place. Father God, we welcome you within this place. Holy Father God, we welcome you within this place. We've come to worship you. With all our might, we extol you, O God, God Most High, and we magnify you in the earth forever, O God. You are good. Sing unto the Lord, all ye saints of Him, and be thankful at the remembrance of His holy name. For He is angry for a moment, but His favor is life. Joy comes in the morning, the weeping may endure for a night. So worship Him with all of your might. We will worship Him with all our might.
extol you, O God, O Lord Most High, and we magnify you in the earth forever, O God. You are our God. Holy Father God, we welcome you within this place. Holy, 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 holy Father God, we welcome you within this place. We welcome you, we welcome. You're the only God.
Hallowed be thy name.
So we're gonna lift you up higher and higher.
Hallowed be your name.
And the whole world will see that you set our souls on fire.
Hallowed be thy name.
You are love, you are life.
you are Lord over everything.
Alpha and Omega, Jehovah,
the King of Kings, wonderful Waymaker, worthy of my offering.
Hallowed be thy name.
You are love, you are love, you are life, you are Lord over everything.
Alpha and Omega, Jehovah,
the King of Kings, wonderful Waymaker, worthy of our offering.
Hallowed be thy name,
hallowed be,
hallowed be
thy. There will never be another.
Hallowed be.
We express how much we love you.
Hallowed be.
You're the only God.
Hallowed be.
And you're worthy of our offering.
Hallowed be thy name.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. We all know that this year has been talking about the hand of God. And we have looked at the hand of God, you know, from so many different angles. It's the same hand of God. And that hand is upon us. The hand of God is upon us to bless us, to mold us, to shape our lives and make it conform to the image of our Lord Jesus Christ and guiding us. He keeps teaching us. He keeps, you know, ordering our footsteps aright. Because the Bible says that the footsteps of the righteous are ordered by the Lord. Thank you, Father, for your hand. We are all in the potter's hands.
Beautiful Lord, wonderful Savior, I know for sure all of my days are held in your hands, crafted into your perfect. Gently call me into your presence, guiding me by your Holy Spirit. Teach me, dear Lord, to live all my life.
Your Holy Spirit.
us, dear Lord, to live all our lives through your eyes. Oh, we're captured by your holy calling. Set us apart. We know you're drawing us to yourself. Lead us, Lord. Surrender our lives as living sacrifices, holy and acceptable unto you, mighty Father. This is this day we serve, O God. We refuse to be conformed to this world. And Father, Lord, we are asking for a transformation of our minds, O God, that you will renew our minds, O God. Every time we come like this into your presence, Father, let it be a time of renewal, O God, as you change us from glory to glory, as you lift us higher, Lord God of heaven and earth, as you continue to let the exceeding weight of your glory, Lord God of heaven and earth, rub off on us, O God, that our lives will not be the same, O God. There is no time we come into your presence, Lord God of heaven and earth, that we will not feel the potter's touch, O God, that our lives will not be transformed, O God, from one level of glory to another, in the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you, Lord God of heaven and earth. We lift up your holy name. Thank you. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. We bless you, mighty God. We bless you, Lord. We honor you. We honor you, Lord. We praise you, King of glory. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord.
Praise the Lord. It's the time for opening declaration. Praise the Lord. Yeah, shall you? Please repeat after me, please. We welcome you here. You are here, Lord. As you stand in the midst of your people, we sense your presence as the great and mighty one. rejoicing over us with gladness, loving and great delight. We will declare your name to all our brethren in the midst of the Lord's congregation. You will quiet us with your love today, and we will exalt you with our unreserved praise. Take full control here and now, as we keep still and know that you are God. Let your glory fill this place and your spirit dwell richly in our inner being. For this is indeed the cry of our hearts as we surrender all to you today. My soul will wait upon God alone, for my expectation is from the Lord. Let all the saints of the Lord rejoice and enjoy every blessing prepared by the Lord our God. Let his word come alive in us today in an incredibly special way, as we are transformed and become more like our dear Lord. In Jesus' name we have prayed. Amen. 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 Can you take your seat, please?
You deserve the glory and the honor as we lift our hands in worship. I will praise your holy name. You deserve the glory and the honor as we lift our voice in worship. I will praise your holy name. For you are great, you do miracles so great. There is no one else like you. There is no one else like you, Lord. For you are great, you're great, and you do miracles so great. There is no one else like you. There is no one else like you. Father, we declare that we love you. We declare our everlasting. Father, we declare, Father, we declare that we love you. We declare our everlasting love for you. Eternal Rock of Ages, that's our declaration this evening. We just want to bless your holy name for this great opportunity yet again to gather together at your feet tonight to come and fellowship with you and with one another. We thank you because you are here to bless us richly. Lord, we yield these teachings into your hands. We ask that your spirit himself will prevail in our midst this evening. Lord, we pray, O God, that you will illuminate our heart by your words. We pray, O God, for grace to receive the word with meekness, so that, Lord, our prophecy may appear unto all. Let none of these words, O God, stand against us in the day of reckoning. Thank you, King of Glory, for in Jesus' precious name we prayed. Amen. Amen. Can you please help me welcome your neighbors? How are you? And for those of us that are online, how are you if you can hear me? I hope we are not feeling the cold. God bless you. I like that. Hallelujah. The Lord is good. All the time. Amen. I'm so happy the elders are in the house this evening, so it's going to be very easy work for me. Amen. And for those of us that are online, we really prefer you are in the church so that we can learn together and fellowship together, because nobody knows it all. We like to see your face. Don't run away from church. Online is good, but in person is better. The Bible says, iron sharpeneth iron. So is the countenance of his friends. Tonight, by the grace of God, our topic says, from the potter's hand to the potter's feet. From the potter's hand to the potter's feet. In this church, we've learned a lot about potters, what they do, etc. So I'm not going to dwell so much on that. I just have an icebreaker here, just an icebreaker. Something to just ponder upon. Let's just, what do they call it in engineering now? Let's simulate it in our minds and see what it's like. Have you ever imagined if we human beings, if we carry colorless skin, if our skins are colorless and transparent, what will it look like? I really wish the doctor. Yeah, assuming we don't have skin, we don't have color, like we have black, brown, whatever color it is. It is colorless and transparent. How will it look like? What will it look like? And we are human beings. We are still talking. We move around. No, the word transparent. Assuming we are transparent and colorless. How will it look? Okay. Yeah, that's one dimension. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Sorry? We will look strange. God bless you. Yeah. Yeah, because we are comparing with something else. Yeah. What else? It will make the work of the doctor's sister. They may see, but not be able to really tell, Lord, sir. They just see, but I don't know what. There won't be chaos. Are we able to, will we be able to identify each other?
Okay,
no.
That's another thing, yeah?
No, but the shape will still be there.
Yeah, the shape will still be there.
The shape will be unique.
We still recognize.
Amen. God bless us. I just want to, you know, just yeah, it doesn't happen. It just occurred to me. God will have mercy on us in Jesus. It's not as if it's somewhere in the scriptures. It just occurred to me that, okay, we call it icebreaker. Let's try and break some ice cream. Amen. We are talking about from the potter's hand to the potter's feet. Can we please open our Bibles to Jeremiah chapter 18 from verse 1 to 6? Jeremiah chapter 18 from verse 1 to 6. And please, if you are there, you have liberty to read. Let's just enjoy the fellowship one another. And those in technical group, please, if you can read too, we really appreciate it. We are so many in the house tonight. Jeremiah chapter 18. From verse 1 to 6.
From the New Living Translation.
You're welcome.
Okay. It says, the Lord gave another message to Jeremiah. He said, go down to the potter's shop, and I will speak to you there. So I did as he told me, and found the potter working at his wheel. But the jar he was making did not turn out as he had hoped. So he crushed it into a lump of clay again and started over. Then the Lord gave me this message. O Israel, can I not do to you as this potter has done to his clay? As the clay is in the potter's hand, so I do in my hand. If I announce that a certain to assist under.
God bless you, man. Matthew chapter 9, from verse 35 to 38. Matthew chapter 9, 35 to 38. Please, if you are there, you can read as well. We have liberty to read. Matthew chapter 9, from verse 35 to 38.
Matthew 9, 35. Then Jesus went about all the cities and villages, teaching in their synagogues, preaching the gospel of the kingdom, and healing every sickness and every disease among the people. But when he saw the multitude, he was moved with compassion for them, because they were weary and scattered, like sheep having no shepherd. Then he said to his disciples, the harvest is truly plentiful, but the laborers are few. Therefore, pray the Lord of the harvest to send out laborers into his harvest.
Thank you, sir. Excuse me. And the last reference will be Luke chapter 10, verse 2. Luke chapter 10, verse 2. Luke chapter 10, verse 2.
New King James Version.
Yes, sir.
Luke 10, verse 2. Then he said to them, the harvest truly is great, but the laborers are few. Therefore, pray the Lord of the harvest to send out laborers into his harvest.
Pray the Lord of harvest to send laborers to his harvest. May the Lord bless the reading of his words in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Okay. Let's look at some definitions. Of course, we are familiar with most of this, but just to remind us quickly. Who is a potter? Who is a potter? A potter or pottery maker is a craft artist who uses his or her artistic talents to create pots, dishes, mugs, vases, and other types of work. Most potters create functional pieces that are meant to be put to everyday use. My late uncle, that's Pastor Kato's dad, when he was alive, he had a ceramic company back in Africa in the part of there. So I could relate with what a potter does. He had some Ghanaians working for him back then. They would buy this clay, put it on their machine.
Spin it, turn it to shape. Dry it up in oven, and glaze it, and for those that are subscribing, they put their names on it, they sell them as gifts and all that. But one thing is common. Sometimes when they make mistake, what they do is just crash the thing, they just throw it away. They hardly have patience to repair or fix, because of course they are producing in thousands as at that time to sell commercial quantity. But our God is different. It doesn't trash us. What a great privilege we have. Also, one thing I observed back then is that all the clays, they have similar color. It is only when they are glazed that they have different colors, different patterns, depending on what the specifications the buyers asked for. So that's why I asked that question in the beginning, assuming all of us are transparent and colorless, and they can see through us. What will it be like? We're talking about potter of the great potters here. This one does not play with clay. It plays with human being, and it can do and undo. And as we look through some of this topic, aspect tonight, I pray that the Lord himself will help us richly in Jesus' name. What is a field? We are talking about being sent into the potter's field. What is a field? I looked at some of the dictionary definitions. A field can be defined as an area of open land, especially one planted with crops or pasture, typically bounded by edges or fences. Some of us might have seen some of these large farms in Maryland. Some of them have corns, large farmland with corns and all sorts of crops grown on them, and they are fenced around. Some of them are used to feed their animals, but that's a good example of a field, an area of open land, especially one planted with crops or pasture, typically bounded by edges or fences. A field can also be defined as a particular branch of study or sphere of activity or interest. That's the one I like us to really pay attention to tonight. A particular branch of study or sphere of activity or interest. God Almighty created each and every one of us for his own purpose. Like the normal clay pottery we talked about before, when the potters make their pottery, their vases or their cups or their plates or whatever it is, they usually have purposes for them, either for use or for exhibition. Some of them are auctioned at good price. In the same vein, the King of Kings, the Lord of Lords, the one that made us, has place and plans for our destinies. When he created us, he didn't just create us because he was idle. Like our daddy general will always say, God does not have time for, I would like to record you. Thank God you are in the house. Please, sir, I'd like to, because we are learning together. I hope you are listening to me. Our daddy is going to give us that dimension again. I always enjoy it. God's too loving.
Too purposeful.
That God is too loving.
God is too loving. Please, can you hear it?
Too purposeful. And too busy.
Too busy.
To create anyone.
To create anyone.
Or anything.
Or anything.
For nothing.
For nothing. God bless you, sir. In fact, that summarizes it all. God doesn't waste his time. He created each and every one of us for a purpose, for glorious purposes. And my prayer is that we shall
fill our purposes in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. So there's a particular area or sphere of activity that the Lord expects each and every one of us to be involved in. He wants us to make a great success of our being. Let's look at some quick and critical reminder. Genesis chapter 1, verse 26. Genesis chapter 1, verse 26. Please, if you are there, you can read. Genesis chapter 1, verse 26. Genesis 2, verse 7. Because for me as a person, I just wonder, what is this word all about? We used to hear the song then when we were in school, secondary school. What's this word all about? What is it all about? Are we just here to have fun, make money, have houses, have babies, get jobs, and then just quench like that? No. God has great purpose for our life. Genesis chapter 1, verse 26. Genesis chapter 2, verse 7. Please, Yvian. Yes, ma'am.
All right. Genesis chapter 2, verse 7. Just a quick reminder. Genesis chapter 2, verse 7.
Then the Lord God formed the man from the dust of the ground. He breathed the breath of life into the man's nostrils, and the man became a living person.
God bless you, man.
And the Lord God formed man of the dust of the ground and breathed into his nostrils the breath of life, and the man and man became a living soul. So just to recap, so that don't forget where we came from. You know, a number of us, we readily forget that we are just vessels of clay in his hands. He made us for himself, for his own glory. He created us. We are the sheep of his pastures, and he has purpose for our lives and destiny. Psalm 8, 4 to 8. Psalm 8, 4 to 8. Please see that there you can read. Psalm 8, 4 to 8. Psalm 8, from verse 4 to 8. Please see there you can read.
What are mere mortals that you should think about them? Human beings that you should care for them? Yes, you made them only a little lower than God, and crowned them with glory and honor. You gave them charge of everything you made, putting all things under their authority. The flocks and the herds and all the wild animals, the birds in the sky, the fish in the sea, and everything that swims the ocean current.
Verse 9.
Okay. O Lord, our Lord, your majestic name fills the earth.
How great is our God! How wonderful he is! He created us for his own pleasures. The Bible says, what is man that thou art mindful of him? Because he has made us a little lower than the angels. Amen. And yet the angels are, they are, what is it called? Ministers. They minister to us, right? Is that not what the Bible says?
Yes.
I just wonder how God has preferred us above all other creatures. What a great privilege. Isaiah chapter 2, verse 22. Isaiah chapter 2 and verse 22. Ecclesiastes chapter 8, verse 8. Isaiah chapter 2, verse 22. And Ecclesiastes chapter 8, verse 8. Isaiah chapter 2, verse 22.
Stop trusting in human beings whose life's breath is in their nostrils. For why should they be given special consideration?
God bless you, man. So who are we? Our lives, everything is in our nostril. Assuming God says he's not going to supply here today. So you can see. So sometimes I'll say, I give my life to him. Do we really own this our life? We don't own it. So I think we just have to, we need to recalibrate our minds. Sometimes we have this over-exaggerated opinion of ourselves. I can do it by my, this is my life. I want to enjoy myself. What's up? May the Lord help us in Jesus' name. If he says he's not going to release here, yeah, this just for 5 seconds, 5 minutes, we see what's going to happen. So all the life we claim we think we have, at the end of it, it's not really ours indeed. They belong to him. He's the master owner. Amen. Ecclesiastes chapter 8, verse 8. I think that puts it more directly, like never before. Ecclesiastes chapter 8, verse 8. God bless you, man. Can we read it in King James? I have King James Version. Because that's the one I have in my head. God have mercy on me. I know it's the same thing.
This is the different version. But right. It's very clear. No one has control over the life breath to retain it. And there is no control.
So that people can hear.
No one has control over the life breath to retain it. And there is no control over the day of death. There is no release from war, and wickedness won't deliver those who practice it.
God bless you, man. Again, that further substantiates the fact that we are mortal, we are limited in our powers, in whatever it is. If the day of death comes, nothing can any man do. Amen. We live long in Jesus' name. We live well in Jesus' name. We fulfill our destinies in Jesus' name. But sometimes it's good to remind ourselves of these things. All the regret we do up and down, if he says, hey, it's okay, full stop. That is it. Matthew chapter 10, verse 28. Matthew chapter 10, verse 28. Matthew chapter 10, verse 28. Please, if you're there, you can read. We're just trying to remind ourselves of some very fundamental facts from the scriptures. Matthew chapter 10, verse 28.
And do not fear those who kill the body, but cannot kill the soul, but rather fear him who is able to destroy both soul and body in hell.
Sir, please can you teach us something from that reference? Who are we to fear?
Fear those who can destroy both soul and body.
And who has that power to do that?
Only God has
the power. Only God has the power. You know, we call somebody say he's the president in Russia, this one is saying whatever. All those things are just human grandeur. When God says, hey, come on, come now, you can't negotiate it. He has the power to heal not just the body, and he can also destroy the soul as well. Why don't we just pay attention to his nudging and to his direction? As a people of God, people that have been redeemed by the blood of the Lamb, we have a different story. We are a unique people. Psalm 79, verse 13. Psalm 79, verse 13. Psalm 79, verse 13. Please, can we read Psalm 79, verse 13? John chapter 1, verse 12. John chapter 1, verse 12. Romans chapter 8, 19. Romans chapter 8, 19.
Psalm 79, verse 13.
Yes, sir.
So we, your people, and the sheep of your pasture, we give you thanks forever. We will show forth your praise to all generations.
God bless you, sir. We, the redeemed of the Lord, as many of us that have yielded our lives unto the Lord Jesus Christ, is calling us the sheep of his pasture. John chapter 1, verse 12. So we are special people.
For as many
that have received him, he has given power to become sons and daughters of God. Amen. Now, when we have been given this power, having received this power, having received this authority, what are we to do with it? Romans chapter 8, verse 19. What does it say? Romans chapter 8, verse 19. Romans chapter 8, verse 19. Romans chapter 8.
For the creation eagerly waits for the revelation of the sons of God.
God bless you, man. He has given us the power as his children. John chapter 1, verse 12. The whole world is expecting us to perform, to do something great, something marvelous through the power he has released unto us. That is it. Revelation chapter 4, verse 11. Revelation chapter 4, verse 11, that's one of the verses in the scriptures. Thou art worthy, O Lord, to receive glory, honor, and power. For thou hast created all things. He has created every one of us for his pleasures. Amen. 1 Peter chapter 2, verse 9. 1 Peter chapter 2, verse 9. 1 Peter chapter 2, verse 9. We are
chosen to demonstrate the wonders of him.
Hallelujah. Who has called us out of darkness into his marvelous light. So God has expectations concerning each and every one of us. John chapter 15 and verse 16. John chapter 15 and verse 16. John chapter 15 and verse 16. Please, if you're there, you can read.
You did not choose me, but I chose you and appointed you to go and bear fruit, fruit that remains, so that whatever you ask the Father in my name, he will give you.
God bless you, man. So tying everything together, God Almighty created all of us for his own unique purpose. I pray that we shall fulfill our purposes in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Now he's telling us that he's the one that has called us out of darkness. He's the one that has chosen us. For what? So that we can also go and bring fruit. When we say fruit, what kind of fruit is he really expecting of us?
So
really, that's part of it. That's one. Fruit that we are bad, yes. But is it possible for us to bring fruit if we are not well grounded in the ground that in the field that wants us to be in? For example, can we plant yam on a rock? That's not possible. It has to be a good loamy soil. In same vein, God expects each and every one of us to occupy some specific fields. All right. Sometimes we think it's only in niche ministry or in church activities. No. Let's look at some of the examples of potter's feet that we can, you know, relate with and we can explore. It could be in business. It could be in sports. It could be in politics and governance. It could be in music. It could be in academia, our lecturers and teachers in school. It can even be in the military. Thank God for that. Science and technology. It could also be in mission and ministry, etc., etc. What God is expecting of you and I is that when he looks at us with that lens, that particular lens, and says, okay, I'll place you in this particular sphere, I'll put you in this particular field. Are you representing me well there? That's what is important unto him. Are we giving him glory? Because he created us to give him glory and pleasure. When he sees us doing our businesses, are we cheating? Are we evading taxes when he looks at us? Or are we doing what is right in his sight? When we are in politics as people of God, are we manipulating people? Are we causing chaos? Are we forthright?
Or do we depend on him to administer the affairs of the people and the nation according to his will and according to his wisdom? When he looks at all of us in any field or in any vocation that he has placed us, what he expects is that we are representing him well. So, dearly beloved, tonight, the question we should ask ourselves then is, what are those things that are necessary for us to be in the field that the potter himself wants us to be? Number one, we must hear him very clearly. Isaiah chapter 30, verse 21. Isaiah chapter 30, verse 21. It says, you will hear a voice saying, this is the way to go. The question is, how many of us have even endured or endeavored to seek the mind of God concerning what he wants us to do, where he wants us to stay, etc., etc.? For us to manifest the kind of success that God wants, the good success, perfect success that he wants, we need to hear him clearly. What does he want us to do? Number two, we need to obey him completely. Job chapter 36, verse 11. Job chapter 36, verse 11. The Bible says, if we obey and serve him, we enjoy his pleasures. I just paraphrased because of our time. And Isaiah chapter 1, verse 19. Isaiah chapter 1, verse 19. If you are willing and obedient, you shall eat the good of the land. Good of the land. But if we don't obey, that means we're going to shortchange ourselves. But you cannot obey when you don't hear. So the follow sequence, we must hear him clearly and then obey him completely. The third one is diligence in whatever we are doing and desire for more knowledge. diligence and desire for more knowledge. Proverbs chapter 22, verse 29. Proverbs chapter 22 and verse 29. Please, if you are there, you can read. Proverbs 22 and 29. These are popular scriptures of the Bible, so, but nonetheless, they are still potent. Amen. Proverbs 22, 29. God bless you, sir. And I like the way that the general started. He says, see it. King James Version, he flows. King James flows naturally. He says, see it. Unconsciously. I love that version. Amen. Hosea chapter 4, verse 6. It says, my people are destroyed for lack of knowledge, because thou hast rejected knowledge. We people of God should desire to know more and more on a daily basis. We should not be satisfied. Complacency is dangerous. And that's why a number of us are more or less in standstill. And it's dangerous. God is not interested in stagnancy. Our stagnancy does not give him joy. We need to know more and more. Diligence and desire for more knowledge will always make us better and successful in the field that he has placed us. Meditation on the word of God. Meditation on the word of God. It's one thing to study. It's one thing to read. It's another thing to study. It's another thing to meditate. Amen. I'm saying meditation, presuming that we have read, we have studied, and then meditating on the word. Joshua chapter 1, verse 8. Joshua chapter 1, verse 8. And 1 Timothy chapter 4, verse 15. Joshua chapter 1, verse 8. Please, if you are there, you can read. Will prosperous and that shall have good success. Amen. We shall have good success in Jesus' name. When we sit by the word of God, read it, study it, meditate upon it, let it sink in, and then we practice it, surely our profiting will appear. Then we have good success, not just anyhow success, not the success in the definition of the word, but in the definition of God himself. 1 Timothy chapter 4, verse 15. 1 Timothy chapter 4, verse 15. What does it say?
Meditate on these things. Give yourself entirely to them, that your progress may be evident to all.
God bless you, man. God bless you, sir. We meditate on it diligently. Give yourself to it so that your profiting may appear to all. I pray that that will be our testimony in Jesus' name. And of course, as people of God, for us to have great success in the field that God has called us into, we need the power of the Holy Spirit. We can't do all these things by ourselves. We depend on him for grace and for strength. Holy Spirit backing and empowerment are very, very essential for us to have the kind of great success that God wants for us in the field that he has placed us. Acts chapter 1, verse 8. Acts chapter 1, verse 8. And Acts chapter 10, verse 38. God bless you, sir. God bless you, man. These are the things that we should pay attention to. Meditate on them. Recite them. It helps us. It helps us spiritually. It helps us mentally as well. Acts chapter 10, verse 38. Still talking about the Holy Spirit backing and empowerment. God bless you, sir. God bless you. That's paraphrasing. Yeah. Yes, sir. How God anointed Jesus Christ of Nazareth, who went with the Holy Spirit and power, who went about doing good, healing all that were oppressed of the devil, for God was with him. Amen. If Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior, would depend on the Holy Spirit for him to accomplish his purpose, how much more we? Amen. Let's not stress ourselves unnecessarily. Let's pay attention to what the Holy Spirit has to offer. In the field and sphere that the Lord has placed us, there are so many things for us to accomplish to his own glory. But we may not be able to do this if we are just doing it by ourselves. Let's put our trust in him. Let's put our confidence in him. And he will surely see us through in Jesus' name. Amen and amen. I think my time is up. But before we wrap up, I'd like us to look at Luke chapter 10, verse 30. Luke chapter 10, verse 30. That's our memory verse for tonight. Luke chapter 10, verse 3. Luke chapter 10, verse 3. Can we read together? 1, 2, go. Go, I'm set. Okay. Let's go again. 1, 2, go. Go your way. Behold, I send you out as lambs among wolves. God bless you. Can we do it again? Behold, I send you out as lambs among wolves. You know that there are wolves everywhere. Even in church, there are wolves. Amen. But we are special people. Tell yourself you are special. So we go out there and do the work of ministry. In business, in politics, in ministry, in sports, whatever it is the Lord has called us into. All that matters to him is that we give him pleasure. We give him pleasure. Amen. And sometimes it's not until we see we are in the company of big people. It may just be amongst people that are of less importance, as it were. You know, anywhere God finds us to do his bidding, anywhere he places us as his feet for us, we're expected to give him pleasure. We go out there like lambs amongst the wolves, amongst the wolves, and do the pleasure of our God. May we not disappoint him in Jesus' name. Do we have questions, contributions, additions? Sorry, time is up. Do we have contributions, please? Questions, contributions, additions. Amen. Father, we thank you for the opportunity to study your word tonight. We give you praise. We give you glory. We ask, O God, that you please do not allow any one of us to wander away from the field that you have called us into. Please, Lord, establish each and every one of us in the field that you desire for us, in the field that you have ordained for our lives and destiny. My Lord, my God, do not allow us to wander away. Peradventure, any one of us has detoured. We ask, O God, for your mercy and your grace to find us, return us, and establish us, and grow and mature and give you glory until we see you, O God, in heaven. Thank you, mighty Father. Blessed be your holy name. In Jesus' precious name we prayed. Peradventure, you are listening on, or you are in the church, and you are wondering, how are you going to live this life? How are you going to make it? You want to be relevant. You can't do it by yourself. You do not have any power of your own. You need the power and the mercy of God to be established and to become what he has called you to be. And if you are listening to me, you've not given your life to the Lord Jesus Christ. Why won't you just call on him now and say, Father, please come into my life. Have mercy upon me. I yield my life to you completely. You are the potter. I'm the clay. Remold me. Establish me in your kingdom. Uphold me to the end. Do not allow sin to have dominion over me. Make me your child. So shall it be. In Jesus' precious name we prayed. And if you've made that prayer, you want to identify with the Church of God, Solomon's Porch Worship Center is here for you. You can reach out to the pastors or any of our ministers or workers. they will be available to give you some guidance. The Bible says, what shall it profit a man if he gains the whole world and loses his soul? Your soul is more important to God than anything. Do not allow the opportunity to pass you by. As you have received of him tonight, I pray that the Lord will establish you to the end in Jesus' name. Amen and amen. It's time for us to give our offerings. It's time for us to give our offerings unto the Lord. Our offerings are tithe. The Bible says, give and it shall be given unto you. Good measure, pressed down, shaken together, running over. The same measure that you give shall be given back to you. Let's lift our offerings unto the Lord and pray that the Lord will please sanctify these offerings. Sanctify the tithe as well. The Lord will rebuke Deborah for our sake, and that the Lord will plant us in the field that he has ordained for our finances to blossom. And the Lord will rebuke Deborah for our sake. Walking like an elephant and eating like a ant, the Lord will terminate it in our lives. We shall blossom, we shall prosper. We shall lend to nations. At the end of the day, we shall see the Lord in his kingdom, in his glory. For in Jesus' precious name we prayed. Amen.
We stretch our hand and pray for our brother that the Lord God Almighty will bless him as he blesses us with the word of God tonight, that God Almighty will water him back, that the blessing of God will not run down upon his life, that the anointing of God will be upon him daily and daily, that the mighty hand of God will carry him in his daily life, that the Lord will be with him and uphold him and strengthen him. Daddy, we thank you for your son, Lord God Almighty. We bless your name for your son, O God. Daddy, we thank you for how you use your son to bless us with your words tonight, O God. We give back your son to you, O God, that you will always carry him in your hand, God Almighty. That the anointing will not run down upon him. You will bless him, God Almighty. Every word that your son has spoken tonight, O God, none of it will stand against him on the last day. Daddy, we pray that you will give your son the grace, Lord Almighty, to continually be in your presence and dwell in your presence, O God. And may your word, may Christ himself find his home in the heart of your son daily and daily in the name of Jesus. Thank you, our Father. Thank you, Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. And so, our Daddy, we thank you for tonight, God Almighty. We bless your holy name for your words tonight, Lord Almighty. We thank you for this great opportunity you have given unto each and every one of us to learn at your feet, Lord Almighty. Every word tonight, Jehovah, we pray that your word will find its root in our life in the mighty name of Jesus. Daddy, we pray, God Almighty, that we will continually dwell in your presence daily and daily in the name of Jesus. That Christ himself will make his home in our hearts in the name of Jesus. Daddy, Lord, we bless your holy name. Thank you, our Father. Thank you, Jesus. In Jesus' name we have prayed. It is time for the closing declaration. Shall you repeat up? Please repeat after me. Our hearts yearn for all of you. Please take every ounce and fully make it yours. We do not live according to the ways of the world. As we daily crucify our flesh, rather we live by the power of the Spirit of God, who dwell in us, confirming we are children and heirs of the wonderful heavenly King. Wonderful heavenly, I'm sorry. What then shall we say as we enter into this new week? If God be for us, who can be against us? No one can bring a charge or condemn any of us who belong to the Lord. Nothing can and nothing will separate us from the love of Christ. For in all things and in every situation, we are more than conquerors. The Lord lives and so I live. Blessed be the God of our salvation. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. Amen. Shall we share the grace? The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the sweet fellowship of the Holy Spirit rest and abide with us now and forevermore. May we dwell in the presence of the Lord forever and ever. Amen. May we always dwell in His presence. And may His presence go with us.
Thank you.